Okay, here we go again. We are starting to prepare for the flight. Here we go. New speed. Okay. Yes, we have a co-pilot. Everything else is okay. So, okay, let's go. Let's start. Wow, it's really, really dark outside. Nothing to see, actually. Okay, here we are. I think I will fly also. Or I will try to well, let's see, get around four to 5,000 feet, depending on the clouds. I want to fly to see the sky, or actually the stars, not the sky. Okay. Yes, I don't like to have everything dark and cloudy. actually yesterday was really nice because I could I could see the moon in the back and in front of us all the stars, and I think this was really nice. But also, I mean, we were flying around I think we were at 10,000 feet. I think so. We probably will have to do the same today. We get there, but that is really, really beautiful. Look at this. That's really cool. Look at this, it's really, really nice. And here's the moon. So, yes, I would say, and even the clouds, I mean, it's, we're at 4.7 and it's still okay. Yeah, here we go. So I will go to 6,000 feet. And then I think it's okay. degree, I think that was the right correction. Yes, the right direction. And here we go. So, perfect flight conditions, and so I hope you enjoy the flight. By the way, okay, and now we switch here. Well, perfect conditions, as I mentioned. Now we are switched to in-game mode, so we have full mode view. So here we go. It's a little bit windy outside. We don't need the light. Okay, I have to go back. As you can see, we are drifting away. I think 2 hours should I think maybe 2.5 hours if everything worked perfect. And there's not much to see here around. I mean, beside the sky, the stars and the cloud. Well, as I mentioned, it doesn't make sense to fly 2,000-3,000 feet if you don't see anything. But I'm really, really excited. I have to check a little bit the update which was provided yesterday by Microsoft on the on Japan. I think it makes sense if you know, if in our direction we want to fly, we see a little bit of some exciting buildings, or historical, mainly historical buildings, or maybe some beautiful landmarks. So I think I have to check and to see what's possible and what is available on the route, and then we'll try, or I will try to get a little bit of some impressions of Japan and the surrounding. I think this is why we are flying here. One part is the mission, fly around the world, and the second part is really to see the landscape and buildings and well, a little bit of sightseeing by airplane. So actually, I was yesterday a little bit, not very happy that that the Microsoft Flight Simulator crashed, because my idea was on Monday, next Monday, to already fly towards the mainland in Japan, so that we can have light. So daylight conditions, and there is a little small island. So I thought that, well, it's a good start in the week. Okay, that's how it is. Doesn't matter. So my streaming deck, I have to a little bit familiarize myself so that I can use it proper, because now I have it. Use it, and here we go. That's cool. Oh, and by the way, you see the water is not clear like it was yesterday, I think. So it seems that there are waves and so on you can see, and that's cool. But yesterday was really clear, everything on the water. So, by the way, one quite funny thing yesterday, I downloaded, as I mentioned, Japan package provided by Microsoft, and it was, I think, around 3 GB. And later on, I also saw that an airport from Paderborn in Germany is available for free. And this was the whole airport was around 6.5 GB. So, I mean, I was it was like, okay, the whole Japan, I mean, it's not the whole Japan maps country, but I mean, Japan itself was around a gigabyte, and only Paderborn, the airport, is 6. I don't know, 8, something like this. So, oh, must be really realistic, the airport there. So I will make a check to see. It will be interesting to see how. Yes, if the microphone is working in a way I would like to. But it seems it's okay. I reduced the volume of the in-game audio. And I think I have to reduce a little bit more. Okay, but that's okay. I think for now it's fine. I'll go back here. Here we go. So, write the message. Hi. Here. Okay, and then maybe I can write another message. Oh, what's happening here? Oh, come on. Well, I think this is why autopilot is appreciated during a long flight. Oh, well, there was a strong wind coming up, pushing me to the south. That's. Oh, here we go. Back on track. That was funny. Well, it wasn't fun, but you know what I mean. Okay. I think I have to. This is why probably a moderator is quite fun, or is good to have, where he can comment things on the questions, and you are focusing on the game or whatever you are doing now. So again, okay, maybe so. It seems to be a little bit windy, and I really have to stop. Okay, here we go. Back on track. Yeah, almost. So I placed my message. So, by the way, it will be interesting to see, this mission I have is in a way interesting. I mean, now I'm the only one in my own chat. It's fun, and I hope someone will find it also nice or join the session here. I think these are I think I have to focus a little bit here on my plane, because I'm now moving left and right, up and down, so it's not the perfect way. It's really windy outside. It's yesterday it was a little more relaxed, but I mean I was flying in around 10,000 feet, so I thought probably this was maybe at 10,000 feet, it's a little bit, line conditions are better, I suppose. I really have to push my airplane now to fly higher. Quite interesting. As you can see, it's quite difficult to keep it on track. Okay. Let's see where we are. Let's have a... There we go. That's really nice. I actually really love this. Look at this. Pretty cool. Here we go back. it's cool. Look at here, I don't know if you can see. There's a little bit of water. But I don't know what it is. Seems like it is water. That's fine. On the shield, on the window. 150 nautical miles left. It is quite clear outside, no clouds, so I hope that at the destination point I have good visibility. So next is the, as I mentioned on Monday, it's also around 350 miles, Russian island, a former Japanese island. So 1924 it was Japanese island, and yes. Also around 350 nautical miles. Well, actually, this is what they mentioned in the log file. They were flying around 350 nautical miles. Probably it will be around 300. I mean, also here they mentioned 350, and actually it's around, I think, 290. I mean, we are taking the direct way, so for sure when they were flying they tried in a way to flying along the coast from island, small island to small island, because it's well, it's a little bit more safe for sure. And here we go. Yesterday actually it was I think 130 nautical miles before the destination point when the flight simulator crashed. So maybe because we passed the border, the Russian border, so. That's the joke. And here we go. So when we pass the island, there's a small island in front of Komandowski Island. Then we will, then I will probably, oh, for sure I will. Here we go. I will go down. Actually, it's quite nice, as you can see. It's almost, there are no clouds. I think that's actually really perfect. You know what? I think I will go down, because I think it's also nice to see with the island in front of us. Why not? I mean, perfect weather. So, let's go down. I mean, we need some highlights. Flying in 6,000 feet. It's nice, but... so, once more, here we go. We are going down. Oops, okay. I'm too fast. Okay. I have to lower my speed. That's the point. And then there, past that. Really perfect weather. Perfect weather for landing at the destination point. So 4,000, I think 3,000 feet should be okay. Really perfect weather. Cool. Blue sky. All the stars visible. And here we go. The sea. Cool. Okay. Quite okay. And here we go. Blue sky, perfect weather. Cool. Now look at this. That's really cool. Fantastic! Wow, look at this. That's amazing. Okay. A little bit wind outside, as you can see. On the sea. Small cloud, small waves. Okay, now go back. Here we go. Where is the island? Really, really perfect. I mean, flying by night and having this weather, it's really good. It's perfect. Can see something. It's good for landing. So, a small island is in front of us. Maybe after this update there are some issues with this map popping up. I don't know. Because it was always the same situation, around 130-140 nautical miles before destination point. I switched on the map to see where we are, and then cloud in front of us. And I was so happy to have no clouds. It seems to be, but no. Okay, so I think next time when the program is crashing, then I will start from the point where it crashed and fly. Well, start again flying to the destination point. I actually wanted to avoid this kind of breaks, but well. Actually, I don't want to fly the same route 10 times, and every time at a specific point it's crashed. So yes. Okay, here's the island in front of us. I see something. Let's yeah, it looks like. And I also will not use the map anymore, so I have to figure out based on the information I receive from the instruments here in the Cessna where I have to go and find the destination point. Let's see how it works. But I think Microsoft really need to fix this. I mean, this is not very... Wow. Dark fog. See anything out there? It's and I have to say I don't like that the instruments are now. I have this light inside the airplane. I actually would like to switch it off, but I don't know exactly the right button to press it, so that I have to wait until I'm landing, and then I will check all the buttons one by one. Normally when I start directly from the runway, it's dark. I mean, it's off the light in the cabin, but now it's on. Side, I see just a little bit of it. Look at this, here we go. There is a small island. We have now in total 90 nautical miles left. And here we go. There is the other island on the left side. I can see it here on the screen. Let's switch. Yeah, if you can see on the left side of the screen, there's the other island. I will see something in front of me. It, if there were no clouds, it probably we will see something around. I mean, there is a little bit of I go outside view, then yeah, you have the island, But that's how it is. I go back to the the other island, Komodorski Island. So we're flying directly to this island now. Here we go. Just want to check. 4, 5. And go back to first. And it looks really nice. Now with everything with the light on, that's great. So okay, let's okay, now the clouds are gone, so we can see a bit more on the left side. On the right side, look at this. Looks quite nice actually. It's really nice. So I will fly along the south coast of Komodorski Island and try to try to find my way to the runway. You know, maybe this was some kind of a hint. Don't use a GPS map, because 1924 the guys also didn't have a GPS navigation map with them. So fly by view. Okay, I will try. But actually yesterday when I was flying and also Microsoft Flight Simulator crashed, I actually didn't use the map. I mean, one two time, but then I switched it off, and actually it's true. I mean, you have everything what you need is here on the map. And I think especially when we are coming to Japan, I will definitely no longer use it, because I mean, you have everything available and visible on the instruments, so it's not really required. And in the end, if you miss the runway, then you have to turn around, find the right angle, and then it's okay. I think it's fine. So, another view to the island. Wow, it's a really long island. And here we go again. Nice waves. Good. Really cool. Ah, here we go. Here we go. There's the island. Oh no, I think this is still the long. Oh, this is a really long island. Crazy. Okay. to go more to the south. Yes, here we go. Here is the edge of the island. Yep, here we go. Okay, 290 degrees. Cabin light off. Where is this button? Okay. Yes, I mean, for me it's very important. I'm a little bit nervous because if it gets dark outside and cloudy, then it's really difficult to hit the runaway. And I'm not quite sure if there's light along the runaway. I mean, normally you have this kind of blinking light, so it's the indicator. So no, ah, okay, here we go. Here I have to go. But the last few times, there was only a light along the runway, and if the runaway is near a town, then you have a lot of lights and you really have to look around to see your runaway and where you prepare for landing. And if you never before landed on this runaway, then it's quite difficult. So this kind of indication light, if it's called like this, but you know, it indicates you, it gives you an advice, okay, here starting point to go down. So and as I'm not quite sure if I will have this kind of indication light, I'm quite happy to here we go, I see some kind of an island. It's quite helpful not to have a cloudy day or night. I mean, there are some clouds there, but I hope that it's just a few, and I can still have a good view outside. I mean, for now it's okay. So can okay. Okay. Switch off the light. No, this will be something very some kind of ziery. Inside the flight simulator, so you can switch the light off, and it's switch the light automatically. Well, probably it will ask you, okay, which light? Outside the light, left, right, 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 the landing light, whatever, navigation light, and so on. And you will say, hey, inside the cabin, the light, please switch off, and then it will do it automatically. So. Or you read the manual. I'm sorry. And this will also be useful. So here we go. Still 60, 70 nautical miles in front of us. Or no, 60 nautical miles, almost there. also see some something around the island. It's still dark in a way. Let's see. I'm going down to 2,000 feet. In a way, now it's everything quite smooth. In a way, I don't need any adjustments or just more corrections with the joystick. It's quite good, I have to say. Okay, here we go. There's the island. Here's the other one. I would like to say hello in Russian, but I'm not quite sure what to say. What's the meaning? What's translated in Russian hello? Okay, here we go. So 50 nautical miles left. Probably will start when we pass the edge of the island. I will start to slow down. We have outside, let's have a shot here, it's 9:30, okay. Okay, here we go. We are flying 2,000 feet. Yes, there are some clouds here, so I hope that we are lucky at the destination point. Yes, that's looks perfect. Okay. Here we go. Looks nice. Yeah, it looks really nice. I have in a way to close my eyes because no, it's all everything dark. I have above my monitor, I have this front light. I have here the light, the instruments, and the light in the cockpit. So it's quite difficult to see outside. Yes, so therefore it's like, where is something? I cannot see anything here. Ah, okay, here. Therefore, I also would like to fly by day because then, well, it's a little bit more clear everything. And because today I have a little bit time, I will then when we are landing, I will probably try to check all the instruments. Yes, I think that's something I really have to do. So, okay, here we go. Let's have a look. Oh, this looks nice. Looks really, really nice. And then, here we go. And go back. So, behind us, the moon and everything. And water and here. Oh, look. No. Nice. Okay. Okay, so so, reduce the speed. Let's go to 1,500. I think it should be okay. The south part of the island, the south coast, I think, and somewhere there in front of us there will be cool. Okay, now I think we get to the fun part. Still 33 nautical miles in front of us. Yes. So maybe half an hour, I would say. I mean, you get also this indicator, the point of view, POI, where it shows you how 5 nautical miles left. I think this is also a very good indicator to finally prepare for landing. Oh, okay, there are these big clouds there. I don't like at all. Oh, come on. I mean, it was so nice without clouds. Everything was perfect. And then I have this dark. It will be tricky, and if they have no lights there, then really, really it will be tricky to find the runaway. So they, I hope really they have some lights indicators. That I was a little bit I slowed down a little bit too early. It's okay. The waves, cool. That's really nice. Okay, so I think I should have reduced the speed next time. When I have 25 nautical miles left, then I think it's okay to reduce the speed. Because now it's I think I will speed up a little bit. Long. Ooh, wow. This is a really dark. Oh yeah. And you can see almost nothing. That's really, really crazy. Wow. Let's have a look. Wow. This dark. Look at this. Wow. Ooh, crazy. Okay. Maybe we can pass. I mean, we have still 17 nautical miles, so maybe we can fly through this dark cloud and then. Everything is clear and perfect for landing. Prepare for landing. So, thank you very much for the one follower. Distance. Okay, seems that it might be that we pass now. I thought that we passed the dark cloud, but no, not at all. Ah, come on. From wing, from the west, or east. actually, like, I I don't know how to land. This is quite fun in a way. I mean, if the whole south part of the island is dark like this, oh, there's something. Oh, there's some red light there in front of us, on the right side. Hey, I see something, but then again, the dark cloud is coming. It would be really nice to see what this. What is it? What is this? Ah, okay. I think we passed. Cool. Crazy. I think we really passed the. Yes. Oh God. That's very good. That's. I mean, it was really, really. 7 miles. Okay, I think I will reduce. Eat. Maybe the best way to lower the speed. But what is this red light there? Here we go. Okay, here we go. Check. Okay. cool. Wind farm. Yeah, cool. Look at this. That's cool. Crazy. Okay. Probably I have anyway to make a U-turn because I'm not quite sure the right angle I have to fly in. But look at this. That's crazy. Fantastic. Yes, as I mentioned, there are no there's no light, no indicators. I mean, they have for the wind farm, they have some red in light, but not. I hope that I can. That's really cool. Okay, let's move. Well, I hope that this is the perfect way for landing. I'm not quite sure if this is the right angle. Oh, we'll check. It seems that it's okay, but we have to see if this is really the right. Okay, here we go. Okay. Wow, look at this. That's fantastic. It's so cool. Look at this. That's cool. It's really wow. There's a car. Okay, I think I have to go back. Cool, that's awesome. Question is, where can I park? Ah, there is a light there on the left side. Maybe there? There? On the right side? Who knows? I think this is a tower. I think there are some on the left side, I suppose. Okay, here's a tower. Okay. Let's check it out. Do I have to go there? No, this. Okay, but we can again see this beautiful. Here we go. There is a parking position. I found a parking position. Oh, that is really, really cool. I think here is a parking position. Don't stop here. So that I can see both. You go. Perfect. So let's have a look. It's 10 o'clock. So finally managed to end up here. So perfect. As I mentioned, let's see again tomorrow where we are going to fly. From Komodowski Island, we are flying to Paramushiru Island. It's actually quite a long flight. It's 585 nautical miles based on the log file. I think probably it's a little bit less. I don't know, maybe 500, 520, something like this. Anyway, we we finally managed to get here, and I think that's perfect. I'm still not sure why this crash, but I'm that's how it is. So see you next time. Have a nice weekend, and see you on Monday back.